Well, grab your drinks or popcorn. It's time for some more epic debunking of the so-called evidences for junk DNA. A study published in the Journal of Genome Research in 2016 entitled Genomic Variation Within Alpha Satellite DNA. Here, scientists were investigating this region called satellite alpha DNA. Now, what is that exactly? Alpha satellite DNA is actually a highly self-repetitive sequence that repeats itself over millions of times in the region of the chromosomes, specifically at the centromeres. This type of DNA, once again, is located in all centromeres of chromosomes. It consists of about 5% of the DNA code, as illustrated here. Now, what's so significant about this study? Well, for years, scientists have thought that the repetitive DNA alpha satellite sequences were nothing more but part of junk DNA, given that the sequence repeats itself over and over again about millions of times, as well as lacking the ability to be transcribed or encoding proteins. Due to its highly nature of repetition, scientists have presumed those genetic sequences were just sitting there doing absolutely nothing. In other words, just being neutral. Yet, this view is actually not supported at all by the researchers from Duke University, as this study clearly shows messing with the DNA's self-repetitive code, that is satellite alpha DNA, can actually lead to some quite devastating profound health effects, such as diseases, birth defects, infertility, and even abnormal cell growth malfunction causing cancer. Not only can manipulating the repetitive code cause serious diseases, but it can also affect the way chromosomes are formed and the genomic architect structure as well. It seems that the key to these genetic diseases may actually be found in the non-protein coding regions of DNA, specifically repetitive DNA, the one that is so called to be one of the greatest evidences for junk DNA. Now, putting that aside, there's actually another similar study that argues against repetitive DNA as junk DNA. Now, before we actually get started, let's take a little biology lesson. For those that have took a biology class once, you may have remembered of something called X and Y chromosomes. That is, males having an X chromosome and a Y chromosome, while females have twice the same copy of the X chromosome. Despite the fact that females have two X chromosomes, only one of them is inactivated, meaning that all the genes in one of the X chromosomes are turned off. So instead of her expressing all of her genes twice, she only expresses one, that is the activated X chromosome. In males, they do not have two X chromosomes, so they don't have a copy of all the genes. Interestingly though, it was discovered in 1949 that in the female karyotype, there is a strange mysterious structure called the bar body. The bar body, the inactive X chromosome that is present in females, contains these weird structures called superloops, structures that have no analog in male. The typical loop in the male genome spans about 200,000 letters of the DNA code. If fully stretched out, it will be about 3/1000ths of an inch long, but the loops in the bar body in the female chromosome can span as many as 77 million DNA letters long. Yeah, that's pretty huge. Now, this is where things get interesting. In females, there is this strange DNA coding element called DXZ4. DXZ4 is basically a piece of DNA where a single sequence gets repeated, similar to that of alpha satellite DNA, over and over again for hundreds of thousands of nucleotides. In other words, to put it in layman terms, it is basically a tandem repeat region where sequences are repeated over and over again with a total of hundreds of thousands of genetic ATCs and Gs, which are the nucleotides, repeating over and over again. This falls back to the junk DNA that we argue recently. Now, here's the idea. How can a sequence that repeats itself over and over again be actually functional? Well, researchers at this study, entitled Deletion of DXZ4 on the Human X Inactive Chromosome Alters Higher Order Genome Architecture, have finally found the answer. They found that the strange self-repeating DXZ4 actually plays a real role. They found that that right after they deleted DXZ4, the bar body and all of the giant superloops structures and so on actually disappeared. Not only did they just disappear, but they also found that the loss of this self-repeating DNA that looks like gibberish actually negatively affected the way chromosomes are formed. They found that it corrupted this thing called chromatin, a special type of molecular protein that helps package DNA together into what is known as a chromosome. You can read more about the study by clicking on the reference on the description. So what role does DXC4, a highly self-repetitive DNA sequence, actually play on? Turns out it plays a huge role in ensuring the chromosomes are formed properly. Well, sounds like repetitive DNA may not be so junk after all. Rather than repeating itself over and over again like a copy machine, as Dawkins puts it, that they are so redundant that they might as well not be there, it plays an actual important role in genomic structure. What's even more interesting? About 50% of DNA is made up of these so-called repetitive DNA sequences. Though DXC4 was one of them, it seems that DNA plays another role than just regulating genes and manufacturing molecular proteins. It also plays a role in building up the genomic structure, that is, the formation of chromosomes. The more we learn about DNA, the less we see it as junk, and the more we see it for possible evidence that could be inferred as design. Sorry, evolutionists, but no junk DNA is found here. Thanks for watching.